Okay. That didn't go over well. Let's get back to the Bible study. Went too far on that one. Now, listen, I didn't have time. I didn't want to go over 50 more scriptures, but let's just summarize this real quickly. In 2 Samuel chapter 11, it shows what David did to get out of this mess. And it was a mess you can't even imagine. He brings Uriah back from the battlefield. He's an honorable man. He tells him, why don't you go spend the night at your house tonight? He won't do it. He sleeps with David's servants because he doesn't feel worthy, since all of his comrades are facing the Amorites. This guy's got... are you guys sitting down? This would be a guy that has, believe it or not, integrity. Can you imagine a Christian with integrity? You can't, but I mean, there are some out there, okay? Well, this guy's actually got integrity. He won't do it. Well, the King David goes, you know, I'm pretty street smart. I'll fix this. I got it. The next night he says, hey, why don't you go home, stay with your wife, and I'll ship you over a buffet, my food. I'll send you over the king's food. See? I'll send you over a ticket to Golden Corral. Failed again. I know this sounds nuts, but here's a guy who actually had integrity. You can believe that. He won't do it. Well, then he gets him drunk. Because King David knows, hey, when I get drunk, my sex drive goes from here to here. My inhibitions go from here to here. Any drug addicts or ex-alcoholics here? Oh, okay. These guys know exactly what I'm talking about. Your emotions and your lusts accelerate as you keep ingesting the chemicals, so to speak. I'll keep this as if I worked at Walgreens. But here you go. He gets him drunk.